In 2001, we started a parish time of discernment to try to figure out where we wanted to physically position ourselves for ministry. Early days, we bought 5 acres of land kind of on the north part of town out by close to the country club and just a nice growing area. And intuitively, we felt that that would be a good investment, and it proved to be. And luckily, there was a building on that land that we could use temporarily for worship and activities. But we had the idea that we'll eventually plow it over to build a traditional church, and this will be a great spot to be in. Well, it got time that we had to make that decision. Are we going to tear this building down, build a traditional church? Are we going to sell this, buy land somewhere else, build a traditional church? And we started about a year-long congregational dialogue, and we made the decision together. And it's quite miraculous. Even though the canons didn't require it, we had a secret ballot congregational vote. And the decision was made unanimously, 100%. I couldn't believe it. It was we voted on the Feast of Epiphany, and that was an epiphany. we decided to sell our property, and the value had greatly increased. And so we made a good purchase to start with, and we were thankful for that. We made some money, and we bought a 4-story kind of mini skyscraper right in the very center of our city. The address is 101 Central Avenue. I love that. I just like saying that. I don't know. But there's two major kind of arteries that dissect the heart of our city. US 41, which goes north and south, which goes right in front of our building, and US 84, which is the east-west artery that goes beside our building. Directly across the street from us is the courthouse square, and so we literally are at the very center of our community. The downtown of our city, like most mid-sized kind of towns, is in great decline. Very poor, mostly vacant buildings, no life, no vitality, not really very desirable. So if you think about that kind of property, it's usually what?
Cheap.
We got that. We managed to get a lot of square footage for not a lot of money. Just to let you know a little bit about our city is that we do have a university of about 14,000 students. That's right up the street from us. A very good-sized Air Force base with a lot of young adults, airmen, and of course young officers. So we do have a pretty good-sized population of young adults and young people. We started our renovations, and we had to move downtown before we actually finished and then just survived. But we built our worship space. We took the entire second floor of the building that we kind of ripped everything back to the original exterior wall, so it's one big room. And it turned out very nice, and I'm quite proud of it. It's beautiful ebony wood floors and oversized large windows that literally wrap all the way around. And so when we're up in the worship space, what we see is we look out over our city. And kind of our rationale and thought was, this is not our church. We're looking out at our church. This is not our parish in this room. We look out and we can see, see our parish. Offices and classrooms and things are on up in the building. And we converted the first floor into a very attractive coffee shop. It's called Hildegard's, named after St. Hildegard of Bingen's. But it's just called Hildegard's. And of course, we do espresso and lattes and, you know, those kind of drinks, and nice teas and sandwiches and performance kind of venue space and meeting spaces and rooms, and we designed it to really just be kind of a front porch, 7-day-a-week ministry of presence and hospitality right in the very center of town. But you got to realize when we opened it, guess who was downtown? Nobody. we opened anyway, and we opened up 7 days a week. And so we started trying everything to just bring young people in, artists in, creators in, musicians in, any groups that were socially active and aware started coming in using the space. And it was amazing that the core values of diversity and compassion and justice issues and joy and celebration started to attract people. And it was neutral enough that all people felt safe to come and go. Within 5 years, downtown has almost filled up. The property values in downtown town have quadrupled. Over 100 new jobs have been created. We've gone from, I think, 2 residents, residentially speaking, to where now over 100 loft apartments. And so we literally find ourselves in the middle of a vibrant, exciting, artsy, creative community of all kinds of people. And we're just blessed to get to be right in the middle of that. And we take serious that they are our parish. Now, do they all come to Mass on Sunday morning? A few find their way there eventually. The way my day looks, my office is actually kind of a glass enclosure, part of Hildegard's. And it's very open, it's very accessible, and my day just really is just being out, spending time with people. I'm naturally an introvert, but I've learned to just walk the sidewalks, interact, and I consider myself that I am their pastor. Most of them, I'm their only pastor. Most of the things we do does not show up on the parochial report, unfortunately. We have an average of 2,000 or 3,000 people a week in and out of our building, but there's really no way to count them, if that makes any sense. And most of them, even though I'm not a chaplain, most of them are, they're college age. So I guess when Dan and the committee and Douglas thought of me, even though I'm not a chaplain, I do spend most of my time with the age group that you do, so somehow I think we can relate, I hope. So I can't imagine being anywhere else. I love my job. It has its challenges. That group of people does not have a lot of money, so we don't have a lot of money. Luckily, we made it by selling our property out by the country club. Spirit always has a way. Again, that's just a little bit about me, just so you can know from where I speak or what my experience is.